Although most people don't want to acknowledge it, we are facing a devastating multidimensional crisis on the Earth. We are running out of fresh water. We are running out of food supplies. We are running low on fossil fuels.
The system is broken. It's not delivering justice. It's not delivering environmental protection. It's not delivering human rights, and it can and it won't.
I think it's becoming more and more obvious that this is a crucial time of transformation on the Earth.
It's just that initial resistance to change. That's how we progress. We put ourselves out of the comfort zone.
This question of what will happen in 2012 may just be the wrong question, and we should just be asking what type of change can we bring about in this time.
It doesn't happen by somebody snapping their fingers. People have to do something to make it happen.
Social, big, huge change can come through personal change.
This is it. I mean, this is our source of life.
The only way we can possibly take care of our body is through a design revolution, doing more with less.
Just that idea shifts the worldview.
Why can't we repurpose the technical genius of the modern Western consciousness to sustainability?
The potential in this time is enormous.
Sting is a big name in a new documentary that's pointing the way towards saving the world. It's a rallying cry that's a heady concoction. It involves such concepts as mushrooms and bioremediation. And its guiding narrator is a best-selling author and journalist who resembles a counterculture figure from the 1960s. So far, the film has only been shown at special screenings, but it will go into full release later on this year. This documentary theorizes that humanity has got out of step with the planet, that a realignment could save us from ourselves. The ancient wisdom of tribal cultures and modern science are seen as solutions. It's an optimistic antidote to apocalyptic prophecies, particularly popular doomsday predictions for the year 2012. It's an endeavor embraced by Sting.
I think there's a lot of very negative prophetic feeling about 2012, as if the whole world is going to end. I think prophecy is questionable. I think the future is what we make it to be. So my strategy has always been to be optimistic, cautiously optimistic at least. 2012, this film I'm involved in, shows that there are good things happening on the planet, positive things. And I want to be part of that. I think it's an interesting date, and we need to make it a positive date and not this gloom and doom, you know, end of the earth nonsense, which I think is terrible.
This question of what will happen in 2012 may just be the wrong question, and we should just be really asking, you know, what are we going to do? Like, what can we bring about? What type of change can we bring about in this time?
It's going to be up to individuals and then communities to make a profound shift in how we're conducting ourselves on the planet.
The film's storyteller is Daniel Pinchbeck. It follows him on his quest to find the new way forward so that a post-industrial world can flourish in harmony with nature. It argues that the future lies in both the application of new technology and an evolution in human consciousness. Quite controversially, it suggests that psychedelic drugs can play a role in bringing about this new mindset. It does seem like a throwback to the 1960s. The film grew out of a bestseller Pinchbeck wrote called 2012, The Return of Quetzalcoatl.
We sort of took the ideas from that book, but then extended it into more practical solutions like ecological design and ways to address the financial system. And then we talked about meditation and yoga. So I'm kind of like the narrator and the interviewer, kind of weaves the story together.
The film features interviews with experts and celebrities. Filmmaker David Lynch talks about transcendental meditation. Actress Ellen Page comments on goat manure. One expert interviewed sees his contribution as very timely, given the oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico, because he knows a lot about the ability of fungi to help repair the planet.
fungi repair ecosystems, and they respond to catastrophia. Right now with a BP oil spill, so we've been breaking down oil with fungi for about 12 years, and so it's apropos that I'm in the movie talking about breaking down oil with fungi, and now the BP oil spill has really focused our attention.
The film's Brazilian director believes the documentary shows that many solutions to today's environmental ills are not far from hand.
All the solutions that we need are already here, and they're mostly in a garden, you know, so it's a message about people reconnecting with nature and really creates not only a sustainable culture, but a regenerative culture.
The film's message won't be to everyone's taste. Some critics will dismiss it as New Age mumbo-jumbo.
Do you think that the people who are participating in this documentary have very good practical ideas?
I think the way to solve the planet's problems at the moment is to think out of the box. And some of those ideas might seem a little crazy, but, you know, revolutionary ideas always have. They've seemed a little strange, but we need to be in that mode at this particular time.
But how much difference can a documentary like this make? I mean, isn't it just going to reach the converted in a way?
You know, you could say that same about music. You know, how can you change the world with music? Well, you can't really. You can plant seeds in people's minds, which hopefully bear fruit years hence. Do we have the time years hence? That's the problem. I don't know the answer. This is certainly something I feel is right to do. But is it going to solve the problem? I don't know.